you are that is done away. Because you are the enemy of Christ. So the first step to death is this. Recognize the invitation of Christ to die to who you are. Now, friends, this is not something that you must feel like in order to do it. Because if you wait to feel like to do it, or you wait for the emotions to arise, or you wait for a charismatic preacher to arise your emotions and to make you cry, then you've missed out the point. This is not by feelings. This is simply you are seeing it in the Word of God. You realize, yes, I need to die. If that conviction is in your mind, then you can take the step. Don't wait to feel like it, because self will make you feel unlike it. Is that clear? It's not by feelings, it's by faith. So make the decision. This morning, if the Spirit of God is speaking to you, and you've come to the realization that this is what you've never done in your Christian experience, then you can do it today. When you die to self, there are a number of areas that you need to be aware of that must go with you. First, I want to know what you know about the state of the dead. Apply it now to you. How much does a dead person know? How much? Okay. How much does a dead person know? Nothing. How much can a person do? Nothing. How much does a dead person own? How many rights does a dead person have? How much can a dead person love or hate? Nothing. And so now, everything we've ever spoken about the state of the dead, you must apply it to the death of self. When you die in Christ, you are making a commitment with Christ that from now on, you have no rights. You own nothing. Your house, your car, your salary, your job belongs to Jesus now, because He is the one who's going to live. Amen? Amen? From now on, you have no opinions. It's only what Jesus thinks that counts. From now on, you have no choice. It's only what Jesus wants in your life. From now on, you have no will. You are a slave of Christ Jesus. Is that clear? This is the absolute commitment to Christ Jesus that we most urgently need within the church. We have a pseudo-Christianity in our experiences. The 10th% belongs to Jesus, but the rest belongs to me. That's self. Did you know that? Do you know what the 10% means? 10 means that everything belongs to the Lord. But at the moment, He's only asking you to return the 10%. So in reality, your clothes, your shoes, your car, your house, everything inside your house, your job, everything belongs to Jesus. Your bank account, everything belongs to Him, because He's given it to you. So now that you die, you're simply returning it to Him. And so, some people may be afraid of saying, but what if the Lord asks me for the house? Well, if He asks you for the house, it's His house. True? He may not ask you for the house, dear friend. Some of you got really afraid when at the beginning of the year I preached this topic from the perspective of surrendering all our possessions to the Lord. The Lord may never ask you for your house. That's fine. He asked me for my house. I gave it to Him because it's not my house. It is His house. And if He says, Sam, sell the house, I sell the house, and I will sell it for what He wants to sell it, not for I want to sell it, because I no longer have possession of the house. And when I sell the house, I will give the money to what He wants the money to go, because it is His money. It's not my money, because I am dead. I came naked from my mother's womb, and I go naked to the grave. And praise the Lord, as a Christian, I can go to the grave now when I am baptized. And let me tell you, for many in this generation, the only death they will ever meet is the death of the baptism. Because this is the only grave that is the real grave for a Christian. All other graves are just simple beds where you sleep. Did you realize that? For a Christian whose life has been buried in baptism, There are no more burial places, friends. The rest is just a bed. Isn't it what Jesus said? Lazarus sleeps. Amen? So it's worthwhile making the commitment right now. Second, when you die to self. So when you die to self, you just simply surrendered all your rights, all your opinions, all those things. Second, come with me to the book of Matthew, chapter 6. Matthew chapter 6. Sorry, Matthew chapter, 6 verse 14. Jesus says, "For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father in heaven forgive your trespasses." What is Jesus saying here? Dear friends, when we die to self, a dead person cannot go to the grave with grudges. True? When you die, all your problems are finished. Yes or no? So if you are going to die to self, and I did this, I had the privilege of going through this experience in November last year. You need to go and go back. Let the Lord take your mind right through to childhood, to as long as you can remember, and you will ask the Lord, "Lord, bring back to my mind everyone who has hurt me, everyone who has done wrong against me, and then empower me to forgive them." And then you'll go through this experience, and the Lord will begin to flash people in your mind that did you wrong, that have caused pain, they have abused you, they've mistreated you, they have stolen, they have spoken evil of you, whatever. And you will take, and when the name comes or the picture comes in their mind, you will say, "Lord, I forgive them. Lord, I forgive them. You know, I was abused, sexually abused, when I was 5 years of age by a man in the town where I grew up. It was an old man. And for many, many years, it was painful for me to talk about this experience. I would just not talk about it. It was painful. It was horrible. And I carried a grudge against this man. An unspoken, an unconscious desire for revenge. Because when self is wounded, self will want justice and revenge. And so I came to the Lord that night when I entered into the death covenant, and the Lord brought this man to my face. And I said, "Lord, I forgive him." And then the Lord asked me the question, "If you saw him today, how would you treat him?" "Lord, please empower me to love him." Isn't that what the Bible says? If you come to the book of Matthew, in chapter 5, the Lord Jesus says, "You have heard that it was said," verse 43, "you have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies. Bless those who curse you. Do good to those who hate you. And pray for those who spitefully use you and persecute you, that you may be sons of your Father in heaven. For he makes his sun rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the just and the unjust." When do you become a child of God? When you take the Spirit of God. And the Spirit of God is a spirit of forgiveness, of love. Therefore, dear friends, when you die to self, self must be buried with all its grudges, with all its evil, with all of desire for revenge and payback and justice. All that must be buried. And how do you bury it? By forgiving and letting go the people who have wronged you. You know, in Worry Move, when I ran the program, Beyond Imagination, there was a man there, a Seventh-day Adventist growing in the Reformed Church. And this man carried a grudge. He had been sexually abused too within the church. And he was completely unhappy. He had been my church member before, and I could see that. I could never crack the code. He had a big barrier in front of him. And when he heard this message, he went home and practiced what I taught him. And you know, the next night he came and gave me a big hug, and his face had changed, and says, "Pastor Sam, this experience has been the most joyful experience of my life. I am free." And his life was completely transformed.